Hey, keep watching to the end of the video because there's a couple of really great tips on how to make sure your imported finale document looks amazing, so stay tuned. Hey everybody, I wanted to share a quick tip on how to convert your files from Finale 27 to Dorico. It was pretty devastating news when I realized that Finale was shutting down. I've been using it since, I think, 1996, so that's almost 30 years of constant music making. And it was a big shock to my system to realize I was going to have to move on. A lot of people I've heard are saying things like, oh, I'll just go buy a dedicated laptop and keep it forever. But the problem is that as new features come out, as tastes in computers change, that means I'd be frozen in time. So I made the decision to go ahead and switch over to Dorico. But because I have literally thousands of files that need to be converted, I needed to figure out a way of doing that efficiently, easily, and hopefully without a whole lot of reformatting if I ever want to go back and edit any of my previous compositions. So today in this video, I'm going to show you some quick tips that I've learned since I've spent several hours now working with Dorico and converting my old files into new files. So the first thing we're going to have to do is open up a file in Finale, and we all are pretty familiar with that. But there's a couple of things we want to think about. The first thing is we don't want to be stuck bringing over every single thing that Finale did because unfortunately, not everything transfers perfectly from the old system to the new. So we want to be real careful about a couple of quick things. Before we do an import, we're actually going to start with Dorico and we're going to make sure that our import settings are good. So we're going to go up to the Dorico settings, and on a Windows that'd be under Edit Preferences, but here on my Mac, we're going to go in and we're going to choose how we import musicXML files. Now you'll notice in this big long list of things, including all the advanced options, I have literally everything unchecked. And there's a really good reason for that, and that is because I don't want to bring over any of the formatting data from Finale. I want Dorico to translate this information into its version. And I've had really good success with this because tie placement, like here, stem directions, articulations, because those are kind of program specific, if you ask Dorico to bring those in, basically what's going to happen is a whole bunch of measures of your parts are now going to be kind of locked and stuck, and it's really going to slow down the import and the conversion process. So the most important thing I've found in my experience is to go ahead and uncheck everything. Now, by default, most everything is actually unchecked anyway, so that's not a big deal, but I would go ahead and take all of the things off. There's always going to be some work to clean up the part when you go from one program to the other, but I found that this saved me a bunch of time. So that's going to be step one. Step two, back in Finale, is we're going to go under File, and we're going to Export musicXML. Now, Finale does have some musicXML preferences, you can see here, but they're pretty small. And so as far as I'm concerned, the default is going to be fine. I wouldn't mess with any of these. There's really just not that anything in there that's that exciting. So again, we're going to go File, Export, musicXML. And in this case, go ahead and export it as the compressed musicXML. Works fine, and it'll save you a little bit of disk space. So we're going to go ahead and hit Save. And Finale's going to chew through, and it's going to do all the things that it needs to do. All right, so now we've got that completely done. We can go ahead and close Finale. So from here, we're going to open up Dorico, and we're going to go under Open or Import. And then we're going to go find that file that I created. And there it is, Avocado Toast 05 XML. Dorico does a pretty good job of preserving the settings and the look because we got rid of all of those default things from Finale. And so the notation actually looks pretty darn clean. And you can see this looks almost ready to hit print. And if I go to one of the parts, you can see they look pretty good as well. So for a quick emergency project, this actually is one of the better ways of doing it, because Dorico was able to put all of its engraver settings onto my document, which really helped level everything out and removed all the ugly formatting. For this next part, I had to change my outfit because I was at work and I had to get going. So I wanted to give you the other reason for doing all of these extra steps when importing an XML file from Finale to Dorico. Since Dorico is largely based on presets and automatic settings, another reason to not have any of those boxes checked is if you go into a document, a lot of the things that Finale pulls in will be taken as an absolute, meaning you'd have to clear all those personalized settings out. And so again, if we open back up that same file, if we didn't like the font set and everything else that was going on in our Finale document, one of the ways we can fix that quickly in Dorico is by having everything set to its default. Now you can verify many of these things by opening up the preferences panel at the bottom, which is this little up arrow here. And if any of these things are checked, that's going to mean that that is going to be overridden and you won't be able to change it automatically, which is not what we want here. We want everything to change. Because say we want to change the music font. So to change the music font in Dorico, we go up under Library and Music Fonts, and then I could choose my new favorite font, the Copyist. And bam, everything in Dorico is changed. Dynamics, articulations, and note heads. And if we had changed things and imported all those extra settings, this change wouldn't go quite as quickly. We can also change the titles of all of our instrument names and our document, again, by going under Library and going to Font Styles. And then we just want to change our default font. And in this case, I'm going to again choose the Copyist down here under the, because it doesn't like to use alphabetical order. And then I would change my size to what I'm looking for, and then I'd hit OK. There's another little secret here I want to show you about the text blocks. You might have noticed that this text block didn't change when I went in and I changed the default music font. That's because these things are actually changed under the paragraph styles. So again, we go under Library and we go to Paragraph Styles, and you'll notice the default text is still this Academio, which is not what I chose in the other dialogue. So again, I can go down here to the Copyist, and then I can hit OK, and that'll change the rest of the text. So our quick checklist here for what we need to do. We need to save it from Finale as an XML. We need to make sure we set Dorico to have no import preferences from the document. Uncheck all of those boxes. Once we bring the document in, we want to look over it real quickly, make sure everything looks pretty good. Then if we want to change the default fonts, we need to go in and we need to choose under the Library menu, we need to choose Music Font for the music notation. We need to choose Font Styles to change things like chord symbols and whatnot. And then finally, the secret one is under Paragraph Style. You want to change your default text font there, which will change all of your title headers, page numbers, and also your staff names. I know it's three different places. There's one last thing you can double check to make sure everything gets imported really well. And again, this is one of those secret ones that's not necessarily obvious right from the get-go. And that is, if your beaming or your accidentals or anything like that look wrong, you might need to change the engraver settings and set them back to the default you have for your Dorico. So if you go under Library, click on Engraver Options. Once you've opened the engraving options, you can click on Reset to Save Defaults if you're like me and have chosen some different things, or you can set it back to the factory defaults of Dorico, whichever one you're more comfortable with. This solves some problems that you might think to yourself, well, why are my beamings wrong, or why are the rests in kind of a weird configuration? And it sure could be something as simple as this. You can also go in the same option. You can go under Library, and you can go to the Notation options, which also has a few of these kind of things that might be in the wrong spot. And so again, you can reset to the saved document, and that sometimes clears up some of those little gremlins as well. So I hope you enjoyed the video and you found it useful. I'll be posting more Dorico tips as I find them. I do write a lot of music for a whole bunch of different places, and let me tell you, the number one thing that gets me is when my workflow is interrupted for having to look for some kind of setting. So I feel your pain for all of us who used to use Finale and are probably moving on to something else. I hope this really helps you out, and have a great day.